Greetings, fellow Wolfens. Welcome back to Winter Fools. Today's mission at hand is Operation Scorpion, which is to. Well, the objective is operation to attack an enemy airbase. And, well, it says destroy all air assets, so I wonder how many helicopters, Gazelle Attack helicopters, rather, we must be facing, that we need to face, or maybe we need to destroy a lot of airplanes over there as well. But let's see, we don't know until we begin this mission and speculating beforehand when we can confirm is rather. Well, foolish. It's a foolish endeavor. So, mission, attack the airbase at objective Rook and destroy all air assets there. The map seems rather straightforward. Not too difficult. I would say that at point number 3, I think that is one of the objectives here. The primary objective, I suppose, because this is, thus far, seems to be the only campaign with multiple objectives per mission. So the primary objective seems to be heavily fortified, and we will, of course, have to approach very cautiously because, well, this campaign is relentless. Execution. And I don't know what's there at objective point 5, or maybe those are just border patrols and objective number 7. Maybe that's the hot extract that we need to clear. But anyway, your insertion point is approximately 255 meters from objective Rook. Proceed west along the road to the base. Once there, destroy both helicopters, just two, and you call that an airbase. I guess not too bad for rebels to have helicopters in the first place. But anyway. Then proceed approximately 300 meters west to the top of the mountain and eliminate all soldiers there. This is your egress point. Okay. That is my egress point. Like, after I destroy all the helicopters and eliminate all the soldiers, I'll get to my egress point. Okay, fine. I see. Egress point, not ingress point. Got it, sorry, my bad. You must destroy both helicopters and clear the egress point of all enemy soldiers in order for this mission to be a success. Basically, it's gonna be hot extract, and they know it as well. It makes me wonder, why didn't they just keep the extraction point at, you know, at an area where it's not gonna be hot? Just make us hike longer for the sake of the safety of, of our own air assets. Expected enemy forces. Composite air photography shows that the area immediately around the objective is heavily patrolled. Outlying areas do not appear to be patrolled. Satellite imagery shows an unfinished SAM site, approximately 250 meters south of the objective, and a fuel depot, approximately 510 meters south. Both sites appear to be heavily fortified. I see. Allied support. Basically, expect reinforcements. Alpha team is in position 130 meters from objective Rook and will join the attack once it commences. Charlie team will insert approximately 255 meters north of the objective. They will move south along the road and link up with you on the east perimeter for a coordinated attack, which is of course not gonna go according to plan because this is Delta Force. Situation. Coalition forces are planning to launch a large armored offensive tomorrow to split enemy forces in half. Enemy attack helicopters continue to aggressively patrol the operating area, posing a threat to our forces. The enemy helicopter base has been designated objective Rook, and its destruction is imperative before the offensive begins tomorrow. Delta team will raid and destroy the base of operations while other coalition forces destroy secondary sites in the area. So basically, it could be that we might be working with Spetsnaz on this mission. We never know. Or maybe the Army Rangers. Nobody knows for certain, of course. And I think they are going to be targeting the fuel depot and the unfinished SAM site. But again, that is just speculation, and I doubt we will see the action in game. Two laws is exactly what I wanted, considering the fact that we have the episodes of the map. And let's see. Let's hope that we have enough bullets for all the enemies that we are going to face in this level, and for the ones we are going to meet. As a result of this level as well.
Bravo! Destroy both choppers!
So we just had a very successful run, and I died to a lucky shot by somebody. I don't know who it was, I just know that it was a very lucky shot. Because their first shot just literally hit me and killed me. So I would call that a pretty lucky shot, and I think I just made a bad move here. by not getting into cover first. But yeah, you just need to clear this area of all insurgents. I'm not sure whether we can call these insurgents or not. I mean, they are enemies, but calling them insurgents might be taking things a step too far. Because after all, they are rebels, not insurgents probably. Why can I not stand up?
I have eyes on target. One bird on the path.
Oh, I fell through. Okay. At least the game didn't bug out, so I'm happy about that. But there are people
Alpha
here as
down.
Well. And we need to be very careful about how we proceed.
Charlie, Alpha team is down.
I've never been on the bridge before, and structures in this
Charlie
game
Charlie 2
are...
is down!
Oh no. Charlie team is dead. Already. At least Charlie was there to help and support me last time around. And you should have seen Charlie play. My god. Was that dude killing it or what? And I think the helo is headed in my direction. Let me just pull out the law. So that I can lay down on its ass. Helo, where are you? Let me kill you. Come here. Helo-chan. Helicopter-chan. You know what? Let me just go ahead and use the burst fire mode.
Bravo is down. All units abort, all units abort. Bravo, destroy both choppers.
Roger, King 6. Of course, somebody noticed me. And I don't know why these guys take such a long time to react, but well, ultimately they do react, so that is.
I have eyes on target. One bird on the path.
That's
Charlie
that's
2 is down!
Oh no, Charlie 2. You were the hero previous time around. Like, literal hero, because he was playing so well. He literally destroyed all the enemy troops without breaking a sweat. Oh. I was a little concerned that I missed
Alpha
the shot there.
Down.
Primary objective achieved.
Charlie,
and
Alpha team is down.
Alpha team is down, which is very sad. And it would appear the my rear is clear, so I'll just go ahead and start my incursion to the front. So, from what it seems, I really need to just make sure to kill everybody on the map. Because otherwise the extraction becomes very difficult. You know, there are probably people trying to hit Charlie. I don't know if they're alive at this point or not. I just wish I could make my friends as tough as the enemies are. Because otherwise it becomes pretty difficult. That guy's dead. Barely moved the mouse, but that guy's dead. On the second shot, it took two shots to kill him. There are some people who are trying to kill Charlie there, and I'm just trying to do my best to protect him. So, thus far, Charlie seems to be doing okay. Let me just go ahead and begin my infiltration. I took a preemptive measure to destroy one of the choppers. So, the strategy I found thus far seems to be working instead of going for an assault straight away. I'm basically clearing my flank first, or rather my rear first, and then proceeding to assault the objective, and thus far it seems to be working. It's just that as soon as I get up on top of this hill thingy, I need to get down on all fours. Yep, enemies over there. I was wondering where they are, because they were supposed to be here by this time. Come on. Yeah, good job. Good job, you died like good soldiers. Yeah, so I just need to keep moving, and hopefully I won't die to these people here. That guy's dead. That was a very long and dramatic death. And this guy, I'm just a little concerned about this guy. Let's hope he gets into a position where I can take him out easily. Excuse me. My throat infection has worsened a little, so you guys might. Occasionally hear a cough. I'm trying to make sure that it doesn't come through in the audio, but sometimes it does when I cannot control it. So in such cases, I apologize profusely in advance. These missions have to be taken a little more slowly and methodically, because if I don't, then it basically means, well, bad news for us. Now, the fortunate thing for us is, as far as objective rook is concerned, like this area, we just need to take out the helos, and that's it. We don't need to do anything else at all. But, for the rest, we do need to still clear the LZ for the chopper, for the Black Hawk to pick us up. But apart from that, I think we do not need to do much. Like, I can literally take aim at the chopper from here itself, and that is enough of an assault for us. Like, here's the chopper, and I can just blow it up from here. And that is our secondary objective. That's it. We don't need to do anything more than that. What I hope I can do, however,
pulling back for extraction.
It's just kill these people.
Good work, Bravo. Move to the extraction point. Black Widow will meet you.
I hope I do not accidentally kill
Bravo, this is Black Widow approaching the LZ. Be aware, you've got bad guys to the north coming in on you now.
Roger, Black Widow. And it would seem that Charlie has died as well. Oh no, that is quite unfortunate. Now, what I want to do is I want to go over to that side. Once I can, you know, safely make it off this ledge thingy. I want to stick to the right side of the mountains and proceed from there. Even though they said that bad guys are approaching us from the north.
This is Black Widow. We're approaching the extraction point. We're coming in hot.
Yeah, so I basically want to stick to the outer side of these mountains. Even though they say that hostiles are approaching this from the north, I cannot actually see them. So yeah, I'm just going to take a little roundabout of a way to make sure that I'm not as exposed. I cannot see any enemies towards the north, so while it is unfortunate that Charlie had to sacrifice himself like that, he could have hung back instead. I mean, I'm not saying that it's his fault. He was very brave. Unfortunately, he was not as skilled as the last time. So, well, we're gonna have to get to the extraction point without any of our allies this time around. Time for us to haul ass. And keep hauling ass until we get to the extraction point. Which is a little far, not particularly close. But I just wanna take the safer route there instead of, you know, being exposed out here. I don't know why they say that though, that there are enemies approaching us from the north. Because there clearly aren't. There clearly aren't any enemies approaching us from the north. That's the Black Widow right there. We are supposed to cut through the camp, but given the heavy enemy presence at this scale, I'm not particularly inclined to clear it. I can already see the Black Widow landing there, and all I need to do is just take out the enemies from here itself, which I can't seem to do. I can see an enemy right there. As soon as he pauses, I'll probably, you know, try taking a shot. Maybe I can take one right now. That guy's dead. If only it was as easy to make out enemies when they were alive, this would be a completely different game altogether. I think we've gone far enough. I think we can begin our ingress towards our egress point. Without facing too many hostiles, I mean. No, definitely there are a few hostiles near the egress point as well, because the map clearly outlined them. The map at the briefing, I mean, and it did tell us that we need to clear the extraction. Even Black Widow said that it's coming in hot, but I suppose that means that Black Widow would want to take out the hostiles themselves, right? As in, they're engaging the hostiles when they come in. But you never know. You never know how this how stuff in this game works. The good thing is this game is open world, so you can actually, you know, exploit the map a little. I suppose that is the sound of our Black Hawk. There should be somebody on top of that hill, and we need to clear the hill of hostiles before we attempt to egress. That is like one of the conditions of this mission. Now, I'm pretty sure that the developers probably did not intend for anybody to come through this way. There's a nice little tower over there. You know, I did not expect people to build towers in desolate areas like this, but what do you know? I mean, communications, it's really important. I wonder if the altitude makes any difference, or I don't know, how do you call it, pronounce it, altitude, but this guy is suddenly aware of me. I do hope that I do not get shot down by them. Okay, back up a little. I suddenly started lagging and I do not want to lag. Yeah. Let me just, yeah. Now, I cannot see this guy. And that is something that concerns me. I do hope that I can flank him without exposing myself to the others. This guy seems to be standing right next to the Black Hawk, and it just makes me wonder why can't the Black Hawk just take care of these folks? I mean, they do have a gunner. They do have a gunner, but they hardly ever use the gunner. Like, the only time I've ever seen the Black Hawk utilizing the gunner is in that one mission where it where we were rescuing some prisoners of war, and the Black Widow came over to help us. Now, there are some more people over there near the tower, are exactly at the extraction point, and I don't know how to proceed about this. I just want to be a little cautious, not assault them directly, even though that it would seem that is what I'm doing at this point. Now, I can't even see them, is one of the biggest issues here. If I could see them, it would make things a lot easier, but apparently that's not like how the game likes would like us to play it. I think they're right up here. I do not see them, I still do not see them. They might be down here though. You know what? Let me just check in the grenade here. Nope. That did not help any. Ah, because I lobbed them too far out. I really like how Delta Force got this detail down right. Even the most modern video games don't. The fact that these grenades, they need to spin a little before they explode. So it's not like you can just lob them and be like, haha, gotcha. Like, this only, like, only after a certain range do they get activated. Now I think I need to toss them a little closer. I just don't want to risk my own life, is the thing that I'm going for right here. I don't think this guy's inside, I think he's inside the bunker. But you never know. Yeah, he's inside the bunker. That is a dead enemy. The only kind of enemy that I like. Let me just go ahead and try to get one in there. Oh, come on. Well, that was nice. Anyway, let us go in and extract. I don't think they have any more words for us. I just want the sand. You have a gunner right there. Why aren't you taking these people out.
Huh?
You literally have a gunner right here, and you're just sitting amongst all these enemies. What are you doing, sir? Anyway.
Yeah, it wasn't as difficult as I thought it was, primarily because I suppose we didn't need to kill all the enemies. If that was the requirement of killing all the enemies was a requirement, I'm pretty sure this mission would have been far more difficult, but I suppose I also have learned to use a little bit more caution in my approach these days. So yeah, I mean, this mission wasn't as difficult as the previous missions in the campaign, although I'm sure that that will not be the case going forward. Anyway, let's go ahead and read the mission tree, debriefing. Number of kills, 23. Your destruction of the enemy airfield was vital to our continued success. Without an airbase on the island, all enemy resupply will have to be by sea. With weather conditions as they exist, the supplies they can get this way will be limited. That is really amazing, yeah. Recent air reconnaissance has revealed the location of the secluded base from which enemy covert operations are being conducted. The destruction of this base and the enemy's main satellite communications station remain top priorities. The decision of which to strike out first will largely be determined by the weather conditions. King 6 will lay out your options, leaving the final decision of which target to strike next up to your discretion. That is heartwarming, I suppose. And completing Operation Scorpion unlocks two further missions, Snowblind, which is destroying an enemy satellite uplink facility, and Operation Whirlwind, which is destroying an enemy outpost designated objective castle. But however, what I want to do next is finish this mission. I think I promised in the last video that I would be going for Fallen Angels, but then I completely forgot that this was supposed to be a POW rescue mission, which would have taken like a way higher priority, and I decided to secure Operation Scorpion instead because it was older. Which is my bad, I probably should not. Like, if it was real life, I would rather go for Operation Fallen Angels first before conducting Operation Scorpion. At any rate, that was it for today, that was it for Operation Scorpion. Maybe I'll upload this after Operation Fallen Angel and none of you will know the difference. I guess you will now that I've spoken about it. Anyway, yeah, when we come back the next time around, we will be covering Operation Fallen Angels. And I think I've been saying that name for too long now. So anyway, thank you for watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.